Hello guys, welcome back to this channel. My name is Smeralda and you are watching Albo Plants. So today I wanted to make a video regarding my experience with Ecuagenera and importing plants from them. In February I received some plants from this company and it was my first time ordering from them. The process of ordering was a bit difficult and very lengthy from my experience. I started making the order since it was the sale for Black Friday, which I think it's in November. I waited for 1 month and they didn't even reach out to me, and after 1 month I sent them an email and they responded that they cannot ship the plants in Albania, even though in their website it was like a possibility to put Albania as a country. So I had to ship my order to another country, which is near where my relatives live, and then they shipped all the plants to me. So after I received the notification that my order was shipped from Ecuagenera, it only took like I think maximum 5 days. So I made this order together with another plant enthusiast here in Albania. She also took some plants. I bought 3 plants and she also bought 3 plants. I will show you a clip of the unboxing that I did. So I will show the footage now. So as you've seen from the video, I received the 3 plants and 2 were anthuriums and 1 was a philodendron. And the reason why I bought them is because I knew that anthuriums shipped really well because they have a very robust root system. And also the philodendron glroriosum is also known as a very easy plant and very strong plant. So I thought that they will be best choice for my first imports. Big plus for this thing is the fact that Ecuagenera ships their plants in Germany first, when they ship here in Europe. So another big difference that I've seen from people that got plants from Ecuagenera in America is that they receive their plants bare root or with sphagnum moss. Here in Europe they ship directly with soil, which is which is very beneficial for the roots because they don't get that big shock to take away the soil and then to process it and to put like bare root or in sphagnum moss just to ship. Here I received them with soil and I could see also the shape of the pot that they were in. So the roots in all of the plants were fantastic. So let's start by showing you after 5 months how the plants are doing and if they have grown or if I had any problems during this time. So the first plant that I unboxed, I think was my Anthurium Forgetii white stripes that I got. And that was the plant that, like, from all the plants that I received, it was in the, let's say, worst conditions because it had some, you can see some damage in the leaves. But the root system was perfect and everything was perfect. Plant was healthy, so for me that's not a big deal. And I will show you now. So this is the plant now. So this plant actually actually from all the ones that I received, was the first one to put new growth. And since then, she has given me three new leaves since I have received it. This was the first one that she put out. And as you can see, this is quite a big leaf, and I wasn't expecting it to directly the first leaf that I got from it to be this big. And it surprised me a lot. It has been like a lot of months that she was perfect. And I remember thinking to myself, like a lot of other YouTubers that I watch, like Wildfern, she has had some problems with her Anthurium Forgetii because her tips were like browning and crisping up. And I was thinking to myself, like, wow, I am so lucky because I don't have any problems from this plant and she's growing like perfectly for me. And then boom, this happened. And I think that is the same thing as the queen. The summer came and the humidity dropped a lot, and she is experiencing this crispiness now. It started very small on this first leaf. It became quite bad on this other one. And this is the newest leaf that it's giving me now, which is still in perfect conditions. I have potted her in a very chunky mix with a see-through pot so I can keep an eye on the roots, and I have added some sphagnum moss at the top. And I have seen that this Forgetii grows really fast. I mean, I have repotted it like 2 times already in bigger pots, and the roots go crazy. They grow very fast, and maybe I can show you. And it's coming out from the bottom also. So yes, this is grown very fast for me, and I love very much the round shape that it has on the leaves, and also the white stripes are very pronounced, so I'm pretty happy with this plant. Even though I have got some issues now, I hope I can solve the problem. So yes, this is my Anthurium Forgetii white stripes. So the next plant that I have received from Ecuagenera was Philodendron Glroriosum Verde. I chose that kind of plant because I thought that it was quite cheap. And to say the truth, I really do enjoy the pillowy leaves that the Glroriosum Verde has compared to the dark Glroriosum, which has a more flat leaf. So that's why I thought to first try out my luck with Glroriosum Verde, and then maybe in the future, hopefully, I can buy also the dark form, or I would really like the zebra one. When it first came, it wasn't like very impressive. Actually, from all the plants that I got, that one didn't struck me at first. Even though I do really love Gloriosums, it had really leggy stems and small leaves. I was thinking maybe they will send me a bigger specimen. But the plant was healthy and it started growing very fast for me, actually. It was the second one after the Forgetii that already started pushing new leaves very quickly. I will show you now how it is after 5 months. So this is my Glroriosum Verde after 5 months in my care. It has grown quite a lot since I got it. This is the newest leaf. It's really pretty. Now I do totally love this plant. And sometimes, depending on the light, new leaves come out with this not bright pink, but very pastel pink with a little bit of coral undertone, which is quite beautiful. And this shade also transfers from the back to the front through the veins, so the veins can be a little bit pinkish when they first emerge. That is a characteristic that I love in this plant. also the dark foliage, velvety foliage, and as I said, the pillowy leaves. It has like these 3D dimensions on the leaves that I really love. So with the Philodendron Glroriosum Verde that I have received, I have made like several chops during this time. As I said, the leaves that it first came were very small and the stem was quite long, so I didn't really like them. My plan was for this plant to push out a couple of new leaves, so it was like a sign for me that she was growing and she was happy. And then I was going to chop it. I was going to continue my main plant through the top cutting, which had the bigger leaves. And the other part I will chop it in node propagations. So that's what I did. And I got a little bit greedy and I chopped each single node. And there were like, I made three propagations. And from those three, two of them were like really close with each other, the nodes. And I was afraid that I didn't chop them right and that I would lose from three propagation, I would lose two of them and maybe just gain one. And I was really sad at the beginning, but this plant surprised me. Understand now that people say that it is a very strong plant, because all the propagations like grew and took very well. So I'm pretty impressed from this plant. I will show you now the propagation that I got from it. So this is the first one, and as you can see, even though it is a propagation, it has pushed out quite a big leaf. And first, the Glroriosum, when you first chop it and the new growth at the beginning has a tendency to grow up like a climber, but then after some time it becomes a crawler. So it is quite interesting to see how these propagations grow throughout the time. So this is the first one. This is the second propagation, which has a bit smaller leaves, but they are more consistent. The first leaf that it gave me was like this smaller one, and then it grew up in size and it's giving me these three other leaves, which I'm pretty happy. And then the last one that took is this is the original leaf, and you can see the stem, it's quite leggy. So this was the import leaf, and this is the new leaf, the new growth point that it has given me. So now I do have, from one import, I do have four plants. She was perfect for a couple of months. And when the summer hit and we had these big heat waves and the humidity dropped a lot, she first started to yellow her leaves. Here is the plant now. So this is the first leaf that it gave under my care, and it's not perfect. It has this damage on this side, and this is because I had to intervene to make the leaf come out of the sheath, because it wouldn't come out. And I don't really care if leaves are not perfect, as long as the plant is growing and pushing out new growth, I am quite happy. So this first leaf that it put out under my care, it's not as long as the other ones that she had, but it is wider, as you can see. And this particular queen has very pronounced sinuses on top. You can see, you know, she has a quite nice root system, and I repotted her in this self-watering system with LECA at the bottom, because I thought that the main problem that she had when she was yellowing her leaves is because she was getting dry quite fast, and I wasn't very good on watering schedule, and she didn't like that. So I am trying out this method now to see if that was the problem or if the problem is the humidity. And till now it's okay. Just recently this part that is damaged started to show signs of lack of humidity, but yeah, I will keep an eye on her. I also did like an experiment with the queen lately. When I repotted, I saw that she had quite a long stem, and I was thinking to myself that it would be better if I try to propagate it. In any case, if something goes wrong, at least I have a propagation. So I cut the stem and I've put it here in this small jar with the same kind of system that the mother has, and it put out two new growth points, but one of those rotted and the other one has pushed out this very cute small leaf. So yeah, I'm very excited to see how this propagation is gonna go and how it's going to grow for me. So this was the update that I wanted to share with you with my Ecuagenera import. What I can say regarding my experience importing plants from this company is that I am very happy with the service. I am very happy with the plants that I received. I was waiting to experience some problems at the beginning because I've seen a lot of videos with imports, and to say the truth, for me it was quite a very easy and pleasant experience to rehabilitate these plants. I think they didn't need rehabilitation at all. Another very big plus that I experienced was the fact that these plants came in soil, so I didn't do anything to the roots. I just potted directly the plant in pots with the same soil that it came. I just added a little bit to fill the gaps, and that was it. I didn't take out the soil, I didn't put them in a humidity vessel, or I didn't put them in any cabinets or greenhouses, and they grew perfectly. I really do want to enjoy these plants in my living space. I want to see them every day, so having like a greenhouse or a vessel to put them in for me doesn't work, because I like to decorate with my plants, and I think that that is the part that I really like. I am aware that I can experience some problems because these are tropical plants and they are used to high humidity. I don't mind having some cosmetic damage or some yellowing leaves, or maybe, as you saw in Anthuriums, the crispiness in some leaves. I don't mind that. The most thing that I enjoy is looking at these plants every day and watching how they grow. So yes. So I will suggest everyone to try Ecuagenera and import plants, especially the Glroriosum Verde and the Anthurium White Stripes. I had had a very nice experience. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and maybe you will stick around and subscribe to this channel. Also check out my Instagram page, because I love to make different photography for my plants. I will see you in the future with more videos and more planty content. Bye!